हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल एंड सेफ एट होम। ओके, लास्ट वीक वी स्टडीड अबाउट द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। नाउ इन दिस वीक वी आर कंटिन्यू फॉर द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। लास्ट वीक वी गो फॉर द सॉल्यूशंस बाय यूजिंग द मेथड ऑफ सप्लिटिंग द मिडल टर्म। दिस वीक वी स्टार्ट विद द solution second method by using the completing the square method. So okay, so first of all, so what is completing the square method? All of you know that if a and b are any real numbers, then a square plus b square is plus 2ab is equal to a plus b a whole square. So from this to this form, that means it is a completing the square method, making a square of the two numbers, algebraic expression, making a quadratic equation. So here I am taking one of the example to illustrate it. The method is common for all the questions. So what is that method? There are two, three ways to solve this equation. So I am taking one of them. The common method is divide the whole term by the coefficient of x square. So coefficient of x square is here 5. So divide both sides by 5. I repeat it again. Whatever the coefficient of x square, you divide the whole term by that number. So it becomes okay. Now, second point is shift this constant term to the right hand side. This is the constant term, shift it to the right hand side. Third point is whatever the coefficient of x is now the coefficient of x is 6 over 5. Make it half and square. So it becomes 6 upon 10, or you can write it as 3 upon 5. It is also correct, but I am writing here 6 upon 10 so that you can understand it. It is 6 upon 10 whole square. So I write here, add both sides. You have to write always add both sides 6 upon 10 whole square. So I repeat again, whatever the coefficient of x is here, it is 6 upon 5. Make it half, 6 upon 5 into half, and take a whole square, it becomes a whole square. So it becomes 6 upon 10, or you can write 3 upon 5, but I am making here 6 upon 10 whole square. Add both sides 6 upon 10 whole square. Okay, look at here the right left hand side. Look at here, right left hand side. Here it is a square, this is b square, a square, b square, minus 2ab. So if you want to be check it, you can check it here. I am going to check here. It is a is 1, x here, b is 6 upon 10, minus 2ab, a is 1 and b is 6 upon 10. So this become 6 upon 5. So why it is 6 upon 5? A term is x here, b term is 6 upon 10. So that it become a whole square of a minus b. B term is 6 upon 10. The whole square. Now we make a whole square of 6 minus 10. Now solve this one. Take here the LCM. Now look at the right hand side. Right hand side should be positive or zero. So that we can square on both sides. If this number is less than zero, then the roots are not real. That means equation have no real roots. Be clear about it. You must check the right hand side when you solve it. Right hand side should be positive or zero. So now scale on both sides. X minus 6 upon 10, this become, so you must write plus minus. So why we write plus minus here? I give you example. If we are taking 2 square, what is the answer? Obviously it is 4. If I am taking here minus 2 whole square, then obviously the answer will be the same, 4. So if I am going for the square root 4, so what we get? Either plus 2 or minus 2, because 2 square is 4, minus 2 square is 4. So that means I am taking here plus minus. That means we either it is plus 2 or minus 2. So why we are writing here the plus minus? So here plus minus, we can solve it again. This become 6 upon 10 plus minus, I am taking here square root 76 upon 10, because the square root of 100 is 10. Now you can take that LCM. So that means the roots are either six plus under root 76 upon 10 or 6 minus under root 76 upon 10. You can simplify square root 76, further it can be simplified. If it is simplified, you can simplify it. Okay, so these are the two roots. One is in the plus form and second is in the negative. So the both are the roots. By using this method, we can find a quadratic formula. Actually, from the last year, this completing the square method is no more in your syllabus. But the quadratic formula and the completing the square method are interlinked. So why I am solving this method by completing the square method. So now we derive a formula, quadratic formula, by using this method. So you can say the derivation of quadratic formula. Derivation of quadratic formula. So I am taking here the general quadratic equation. This is the general quadratic equation. Okay, so the first step is divide the whole term by the coefficient of x square, that is a here. So divide both sides by a. So this become is one and the same thing, distinct, or you can say unequal. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are real and equal. The both answer, when we solve this formula, the both roots are same, or you can say equal. And the third condition, this is the first condition, this is the second condition. The third condition is, if b square minus 4ac is negative, or you can say less than 0, then these roots are not real. This kind of roots are known as imaginary roots. About this we studied in class 1. Okay, so these are the three forms of discriminant. So if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then roots are real and unequal, or you can say distinct. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then roots are equal and real. The third one is, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, means negative, then roots are not real. So these are the three forms of this part. This is known as discriminant. So it is our concern about this discriminant. Normally we represent this as B, capital D. So D is here, B square minus 4ac. So now we go for one or two examples. Find the roots by using quadratic formula if exist. So I am taking one of the example here. Dx square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay. Look at here. I am solving this question by using quadratic formula. Find the roots of equation by using quadratic formula if exist. The question is if exist. Just means first we check this one. This is a discriminant. First we check the discriminant. Either the roots are real or not real. So here a is 3, b is minus 5, c is 2. I am comparing it with the Jordan equation. General equation all are known, it is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So I am comparing with this. A is coefficient of x square, b is coefficient of x, c is a constant. So first of all, I am calculating here b, that is discriminant. Minus 5 square, 4 into 3 into 2. So it is 25 minus 24. It is 1. Here b is greater than 0 because of the positive 1, so it is greater than 0. Therefore, roots are real and unequal, or you can say distinct. Okay, now x is equal to the variables here, x what are the variables here? We will write here. X is equal to minus b plus minus b upon 2a. So b, the value of b here is minus 5 plus minus 1 upon 2a. A is 3. Put here the value. So when we solve it, it become like this. So x is equal to, either it is equal to 5 plus 1 upon 6 or 5 minus 1 upon 6. Take 1 as first time as positive or second time negative, or you can make it a reverse. First time negative, second time positive. So this become 1 or 2. So these are the roots. By using this method, you can find the scale of any quadratic equation, but the roots must be real. This is one of the conditions. So you can find the roots by using the quadratic formula. I am taking one more example for this. The equation is x square plus 4x plus 5 is equal to 3. Okay. Here a is 1, b is 4, c is 5. So first we calculate the discriminant here, which is b square minus 4ac. So it is 4 square minus 4 into 1 into 5. So it is 16 minus 20. It is minus 4. We write here b is less than 0, therefore roots are not real. Or you can write roots will not exist. This question is over here. Because of the negative, we can't find the roots here. So that is why it is not real. I am taking one more example here. In this, a is 2, b is minus 2, and c is 1. So first we calculate discriminant here. So this become 8 minus 8, 0. Right here, b is equal to 0. So roots are real and equal. Now the further, x is equal to minus b plus minus discriminant over 2a. B is minus 2 root 2 plus minus, it is 0, upon 2a. This become 2 root 2 plus minus 0 over 2. Because of the 0, there is no difference between the two. प्लस जीरो और माइनस जीरो, सो देयर इज नो सच डिफरेंस, सो दैट इज व्हाई द रूट्स आर बिकॉज ऑफ द जीरो, नो एडिशन नो सब्ट्रैक्शन, सो दैट इज व्हाई द रूट्स आर इक्वल. So these are the some examples to find the roots of the quadratic equation by using the method of quadratic formula. I am making one more example here.
Thank you.
Okay, now x is equal to minus b plus minus d upon 2a. The value of b is minus 6 plus minus the value of d is 12 upon 2a. A is 3. So this becomes, now you can solve it. This 12 can be written as exactly as 2, 3. Because you can separate it, 12 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3. So here, who is making up here? So I am taking here as 2 root 3 upon 6. So this become 6 plus 2 root 3 upon 6, 6 minus 2 root 3 upon 6. You can take here 2 as common. Similarly here, so this become
and the second one is 9 into 2 root 6. So I'm taking now one of your statement question. I am taking question number 9 of your exercise 4.3. This question is, two water taps together can fill a tank in 9 3/8 hours. The tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one to fill the tank separately. Find the time in which each tap can separately fill the tank. This is your question number 9 of your exercise 4.3. The question is exactly the two taps are given. One is of a greater diameter and the other has smaller diameter. And greater diameter tap fill the tank 10 hours less than the smaller diameter tap taken the time. So I am taking here, let the time taken by smaller diameter type tap to fill the tank be x hours, then time taken by greater diameter tap to fill the tank, it is 10 hours less. So it is x minus 10 hours. Okay, now what is the 1 hour work of this tap? It is all according to the statement. 1 upon x plus. This time taken x minus 10. So 1 hour work of this greater diameter is x minus 10. Both can do the same work in 9 3/8 hours. That become 75.8 actually, 9 3/8, 75.8 hours. So both tanks time is given 75.8. So that means both step 1 hour work become 8/75. Now you can solve it by using LCM. 75 into x minus 10, 8x into x minus 10. The very simple, it is very, very much of the Tukka method. So what you can do, multiply this term by the denominator of this and this. Multiply this term by this and this, and this term by the denominator this. that is I written here. Solve it. Okay, make a quadratic question here. Now you can solve by using any method. Haan ji ma'am. Okay students, so you can solve this equation by using any method, either by the subtracting method or by using the quadratic formula. You can find the value of x here, but if you find the value of x, then you can find the value of time taken by the smaller dial tank and the greater dial cap tank. Okay, then you have to now complete these two exercises, 4.3 and 4.4 of your NCERT book. Make sure if you have any query, then you can ask me on a Google class. So I am binding here. Okay students, be safe and care yourself.